Hello friends, welcome to chemistry classes. Today I am going to discuss about the one of the important topic in group theory. The topic is character table. Character table. First of all, what is character? Character is equal to sum of the diagonal elements. Sum of the diagonal elements is called as character. It is represented to the this symbol. Now, for example, identity element G1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, and another one is C2 Z is minus 1 0 0 0 minus 1 0 0 0 1. These two elements character is sum of the diagonal elements. This is the sum of the diagonal elements. Identity element character is 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 3. But in the case C2Z, character is minus 1 plus minus 1 plus 1 is equal to minus 1. This is the character. And another one, I will explain the one of the important term that is called as representation. Now, first of all, what is representation? Representation is a simply nothing but the collection of the all the symmetry elements. The symmetry elements having a matrix. It's having a character that is called as representation. In representation is simply nothing but the collection of the character of the symmetry elements. It make a representation. In representation is a two types. One is reducible representation, and another one is irreducible representation. Now, what is reducible representation and irreducible representation? In reducible representation is a simply nothing but it is reduced to the representation. It means it is divide into the smaller representation of the representation. But in the case irreducible representation is a, it is does not reduce to the representation, it is a smallest one. Smallest one. This is called as reducible representation and irreducible representation. Now I am explain the what is character table. This is, these terms are used for the character table. Now I will explain the character table. Character table is a simply nothing but collection of the all the characters in a irreducible representation of a particular point group, that is called as character table. This character table is divided into four columns divided into six parts, that is called character table. Now like this is four columns divided into six parts. 1 2 3 4 5 6. In four columns divide into six parts, that is character table. In first one is point group, and second part is in symmetry elements, and third part is in Mulliken symbol for the IRs, irreducible representation. Fourth one is the characters of irreducible representations, and fifth one is the translational, like this one. Fifth one is the translational axis, like x, y, z, and r plus rotational axis, like rx, ry, and rz. This is the fifth one. In case sixth one is the quadratic functions. Quadratic functions like xy and yz and zx are x square, y square, z square. These are the x square, y square, z is the squares of the Cartesian coordinates. This is the character table. First one is the character table is a point group. For example, in any molecule, find out the point group in character table, this position. Second position is in symmetry elements, and third one is in Mulliken symbol for the irreducible representation, and fourth one is the characters of IRs, means irreducible representation. This is this one, and fifth one is the translational axis, like x, y, z, and rotational axis rx, ry, rz. In sixth one is the quadratic functions like xy, yz, zx, x square, y square, z square. This is the character table, and these two are the very important. These two are the period. Find out the Raman or IR active. Raman or IR. IR active modes. This is the character table. Now one example, what find out the character table. The example is water molecule. Water molecule. Water molecule is a C2V point group. Now, what is the character table for the C2V point group? C2V point group. Character table for C2V point group. First of all, the diagram is, character table is like this. This one, first one is the find out the point group. Point group for the water molecule is C2V. And second one is the symmetry elements. Symmetry elements for the C2V point group is identity. And second one is the C2Z. And third one is the sigma XZ plane. And third one, fourth one is the sigma YZ plane. This is the symmetry elements. And another one is the irreducible representation. In irreducible representation is like A1, A2, B1, B2. This is the irreducible representation. It's called as Mulliken symbols. In this column is represented to the characters of these symmetry operations, such the symmetry elements. The characters is 1 1 1 1 1 1 1. This is 1 minus 1 and minus 1. Therefore this is minus 1 1 minus 1 and minus 1 minus 1 1. This is the characters of the symmetry operation. And This is the fourth, fifth column. Column is a translational or rotational axis, like Z axis. This is Z, then this one is R Z, and this is X and R Y. This is Y and R X. Sixth one is the quadratic functions. This were X square, Y square, and Z square. This is XY, Y and XZ and YZ. This is the character table for the C2V point group. This is the character table for the C2V point group. Now, first of all, one by one explain. This is the point group, and second part is the symmetry elements A, C2Z, sigma XZ, sigma YZ. And this is third portion. This third portion is, this is the A1, A2, B1, B2. These are the Mulliken symbols. Sometimes this is represented to the like these symbols. This is called as gamma 1 and gamma 2, gamma 3 and gamma 4. These called as the beta notation. These called as Mulliken symbol. Now, first of all, discuss about the Mulliken symbol. Mulliken symbol is A, B, E, T. For example, in the A and B is decide about the Mulliken symbol is character of identity element. If the character of identity element is one dimensional, means one, that is called A and B. If the character of identity element is two dimensional, like two, that is called character of identity element is three, that is called three dimensional, that is called Mulliken is T. This is the Mulliken symbols. But and in the case the A and B is decide about the Mulliken symbol is decide about the Mulliken symbol is principal axis. In case H2O, this is called as C2 point group. C2Z axis is C2Z, like this is principal axis is positive, the Mulliken symbol is A. It is negative, means unsymmetrical or anti-symmetrical, this is B. In case this is the positive, the value is A, but it is negative is B. But is 1 and 2 is decide about the sigma XZ. Sigma XZ means origin, means vertical plane. The vertical plane is positive, its value is 1. The vertical plane is negative, the value is 2. This is subscript 1 and 2. In case this is a sigma XZ plane is minus 1, therefore this is 2, and plus 1, this is 1. This is the Mulliken symbol. And another subscript is G and U. G and U is decide about the subscript is inversion. If the inversion character is positive, means symmetrical, the subscript is G. Its inversion is negative, the subscript is U. And another one is the super subscript, means super subscript is dash or double dash. If the dash is the sigma H character is positive, it is dash. But sigma H character is negative, it means anti-symmetric, therefore the subscript is double dash. These are the Mulliken symbol for the involved in the dash or double dash. This is the concept of the Mulliken symbol. And I will explain them. And another important term, these are the 1 1 1, these are the characters of the these symmetry elements. Now, and another important term is fifth one. This is called as transformations of axis or rotational axis. In first of all is z axis is a transformation of pz orbital. The transformation of pz orbital, what happened? They apply to the this symmetry operation, the values are represented like this is z axis and y axis and x axis. Therefore pz orbital like this is the pz orbital. This orbital is along the z axis. Now what happened? The apply to the symmetry elements, in first of all apply to the identity, they apply to the identity elements, rotate about 360 degrees. This pz orbital is not changing the sign, therefore this sign is positive, it means 1. But in case it's applied to the c to z, means 180 degrees, rotate about 180 degrees, these nodes are not changed, the sign is positive, this is value is -1. Apply to the another operation is sigma x, this is xz plane. The xz plane is this direction, this node is does not changes, this is sign is positive. And apply to the sigma yz, it means the plane is like this, therefore this is does not changes to the this node, the sign is positive, this is positive. The positive values are present in the this transformation of pz orbital, like the Mulliken symbol is our irreducible representation is because of the identity is positive, the Mulliken symbol is our irreducible representation is A1. In principal axis c to z is also positive, therefore this is A2. This is the z axis transformation of pz axis, transformation of pz orbital. These values are present in this position. And another one is the x-axis transformation of px orbital. In case px orbital is like this, this is the z axis, this is y axis and x axis, the px orbital is like this. This is the x orbital. They apply to the symmetry elements like identity operation. This identity rotate about 360 degrees, the value sir does not change, therefore it's having a positive sign are present in there. And another one is it is applied to the c to z, it means 180 degrees, this is 180 degrees is rotate about the this node is present in this position, this is present in the this position, therefore negative sign is present in the c to z is applied to the this px orbital, therefore this is -1. And another one is the sigma xz is applied to the this x axis like px orbital. The sigma xz plane is like this, therefore this is does not changes to the this node, the value is positive, means +1. In case it is applied to the sigma yz is applied to the this node, this px orbital like this direction, therefore this x orbital is becomes to the back side and back side is become to the front side, therefore this orbital of the nodes is changes, it means negative sign like -1. These values are present in the px orbital. In x is like 1 -1 1 -1, these values, therefore it's having a identity is positive, it means b r a and b, and it is -1 is present in principal axis, it means b, and sigma xz is a positive, it means 1. This is the b1 is the irreducible representation of the x-axis transformation of px orbital. In irreducible representation is a B1. And another important one is y-axis transformation of px orbital. Y-axis means py orbital. In py orbital is like this. This is the z-axis and this is y-axis and x-axis. This is along the y-axis. When it is applied to the identity, the values does not change. It is having a rotated about 360 degrees. It is having a positive sign means 1. And applied to the C2Z, it means C2Z is the rotated about 180 degrees. This y is the changes to the in this position. Therefore, negative sign is present in the node. And another one is the sigma xz. It's having sigma xz plane is like this. This node is become to the in this position. This is node is become to the in this position. Therefore, negative sign is present in there. And another applied to the sigma yz. It means sigma yz is like this. Therefore, this is does not change as to the these nodes. It's having a positive sign. And plus 1, minus 1, minus 1, plus 1. In case y is a 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Therefore, in y is a b2, irreducible representation is present in the this position. And another one is the an important one is the and another one we have to going to discuss about the dxy, that is called dxy orbital. Transformation of dxy orbital. What happened? The symmetry operations are applied to the what values are represented. In this dxy orbital is like this. This is the x-axis and y-axis. This is the dxy orbitals. The z direction is like this, this position. Z direction is like this position. And applied to the identity, they apply to the identity rotate about 360 degrees. Therefore, these nodes are does not changes. The values are is sign is positive, it means 1. And apply to the C2Z, 2Z axis is present in there, like this, this direction, C2Z is present in there. The nodes are, these two nodes are present in there, this position, because these two nodes are does not changes. Therefore, the value is, positive sign is present in there, therefore, plus 1. In case sigma xz plane is present in there, the sigma xz plane is like this. This is z axis and x axis. The sigma xz plane is present in there. The value is changes becomes it is the nodes are negative signs is present in there. Therefore minus 1. In case sigma yz plane, the sigma yz plane is like this. Therefore one node is changes. It means negative sign is present in there. Therefore minus 1. And it is positive, positive, negative, negative. In case sigma xy is 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1. Therefore, the irreducible representation of for the dxy orbital is A2. It means A is a the identity of elemental character is positive, it means plus 1, and 2 is the it is the vertical plane is minus 1, it means 2. This is the irreducible representation of the dxy orbital. This is the concept of the CTV point group for the character table. Use it for the these transformation of orbitals. This is the concept of the CTV point group character table. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.